Hello, I'm Ant.
I'm Hannah.
That's Mabel.
And this is Art in the Corridor. Hello everyone.
Afternoon, folks. We've got a confession.
Turning myself upside down again. Calling for words to fulfill my lies. Crazy thoughts from a tired mind.
Thank you all very much for watching our last video. We were really surprised by the amount of comments and that kind of thing we received. And we thought we'd take the time now to dish out a little confession. We're not really trained artists.
We got no training. We're lacking it.
So it's actually probably more of a disclaimer than a confession. So we had a load of comments and people were saying to me, where did you train?
Where did you train, Andy?
Where did I train? I didn't. I'm not a trained artist.
Well, I'm sure there's loads of self-taught people out there.
Yeah. Up until 2019 or 2027 or that,
yeah.
I was a decorator and I'd been a decorator for nearly 20 years. And we all went into lockdown and all that stuff happened. And I just started trying lino prints. And drawing's always something I've done since I was a kid. I've always spent spare time sitting drawing and that sort of thing. And I really enjoy art, but I've never actually done any art training. Anything further than GCSE art. It was always something I actually wanted to do. I would have really liked to go to art college or maybe do a degree at university, but yeah, it just never happened. I have done a degree in music production. I haven't used it. But yeah, so the lino thing was more of just like a bit of a trial and error, and I just practiced and sort of went from there really. I mean, I posted a picture of the bendy boat, which a lot of people have probably seen, and it just sort of took off. Loads of people started saying, oh, can I buy a copy of that picture? And before you knew it, we were just sort of in a situation where we said, oh, we'll give this a go, you know.
I think you said, right, I'm going to try this for a year.
Yeah, I did. I
so thought, at least I've tried it.
Yeah, we said, right, we'll give it a whole year, see what we can do with it.
Yeah, just have a go, have a crack.
Yeah. The last 2 years, we've sort of been really surprised at how well it's all been going. I never thought that I'd be able to make a living just carving lino prints, but we have. And Hannah does some really nice watercolour commissions for people of their boats and that sort of thing. And it's been sort of, I don't know, like a big surprise to us really, isn't it? Like, a bit of like a dream come true in some ways.
Thanking our lucky stars.
Yeah. But then what we've noticed this year, from January, I think everybody's felt the cost of living crisis in a hard way. And although we're still selling work and, you know, we're still surviving, we noticed that the sales were slowly tailing off a little bit. So one of the main reasons we wanted to do this channel was just to reach a wider audience and just show more people what we do. Yeah.
And trading gives you that because you meet loads of different people from all different walks of life.
Yeah, because
well,
the last few years, we've sort of been going out on the boat, trading, you know, along with Kay.
Yeah.
Kay on P Green and Vic and Joe from Holly the Cafe Boat. We've been trading with them last year.
They always bring a good crowd.
They can pull a crowd. So just sort of going back to this whole idea of not being a trained artist, when I first started trying to make reduction lino prints, I thought, how on earth do you line up the layers? And I've had a few messages about my little system for doing that from the last video, and all I do is I make this really simple little registration board, and it's just a normal piece of cardboard, and all I've done is these little pegs at the end here. You see these little pegs? Well, they're just the ends of sort of little thumbtacks, like little drawing pins, and you find them in like Ryman's and stuff like that, and they're just in a little clear plastic pot. And all I've done is put my piece of lino onto this piece of card, drawn around it and cut out this insert, so then your piece of lino just sits straight in there and it can't move anywhere. And by using a regular hole punch, you can set the distance of these two little holes, push your tacks through without the pins in the end, snap them off. And then when you use your hole punch on your paper, obviously it's then going to line up perfectly. Let me just spin you around. Yeah, so these two holes are perfect distance apart because they've been done with a hole punch. This paper's been done with a hole punch. So obviously when it's the paper's put onto this, you lay it across your piece of lino, print your layer, do your next layer, everything stays still. Nice and simple. So here we have a few prints that are going out today. This was the print we made on the last video, into the light. And as you saw before, this is a reduction print, so we've done all the layers. But we're going to, on this episode, go back to the sort of basics and do a black and white print. This was the bendy boat I was talking about that sort of started it all, really. And here's a few more of the boaty ones. This is how I like to sell them, in mounts with the titles and signed and dated and stuff on the back. And today we will be making
that fella.
This fella.
So black and white's an easier process, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just one lot of carving. And
so
then,
it's like a real good place for people to start.
Yeah, so we'll take a look at that.
And they can keep being printed and printed and printed because it's just one layer, so you've still got the material.
They can, yeah.
Let's go.
So this is the sketch we're going to be working on today. It's just a man sort of pulling a boat under a canal bridge. And my hope for this really is just to make it really simple, almost just silhouettes and light bursting through. It's going to be one layer of ink, just black, and that will make this an open edition print, which means we can just print it off over and over again. It won't be a limited edition. Start cutting our piece of lino now. For this particular picture, I'm just going to start working my way around these edges, because this is all going to be dark and the light's going to be coming out from behind it.
Clever you and me and I, come with a hum so it's easy. There's panic in the habit when the people find their waiting, shaming, greases. When you wonder why you let
happily directionless now. We're happily directionless.
I think this is done for the moment. I'm not 100% sure how it's going to look when we get the ink on, but that's the carving done. And like I say, this is going to be an open edition print, so it'll just be black ink on top of this. The areas that are cut will stay white on the page, and hopefully we'll get a pretty cool effect, and this will be able to be printed over and over again, which is very good.
It's best to let it go. Hard done, but easier than cricket. Faster than metal in a bowl. Oh no, there's evil in the kitchen. So low, it's best to let it go. Hard done, but easier than cricket. Faster than metal in a bowl. Oh no, there's evil in the kitchen. So low, it's best to let it go. Hard done, but easier than cricket. Faster than metal in a bowl. Oh no, there's evil in the kitchen. So low, it's best to let it go. Hard done, but easier than cricket.
Freezing cold air coming through the tunnel, and it's actually a really hot day,
and it smells really musty, like really musty.
Let's have a look at the plaque.
'1796.
Wow, that's mental.
It smells like 1796.
We're gonna get wet.
Takes us to the best shelter, but this is I'm not feeling this one.
No, this is not
I'd
really
say this
working.
Is 2 out of 10 stars. You usually take us to a much better shelter than this, my book. Bird shrilling off goes off her head. Went absolutely bonkers at a bird outside earlier. Now she's completely sparkers. I don't get it.
Uncle's
completely spotless. Don't see
anyone. All right.
Just found a load of water all over the floor.
Coming up.
And took the carpet tiles up, realised we had an inspection hatch here and it was full of water. We've just drained it all out, mopped it up. Really no idea where that's coming from. Instantly I panicked because we did actually nearly sink once. Looked in the bilge. Bilge looks normal. It's got the normal amount of rainwater in it.
So where's that coming from?
It's the next morning. We're okay. We survived. Basically, we had like a flash flood. There was so much rain and hailstone. I looked out the back the day this morning and all the gunnel holes were like completely blocked. Usually I only cleaned them up about a week ago, but they've got blocked up already. So it had all just, all the water had sat in that corner and the hailstones had piled up and it had just somehow got in. I think it went through the vent, like for the engine bay, and it had gone down and underneath. Always a little bit of a shock when you see water in places where it shouldn't be on a boat, especially because we did actually nearly sink once about 4 years ago. At Denver Sluice, going into Salters Load on the river. If you know that area, you'll know it's not a great place to be taking on water. But we're okay, we've got a porridge, it's the next day, we're ready to crack on. We've got a competition, haven't we?
Yep.
We've got a competition to announce.
Yep.
Let's go.
Good morning, madam. How are you getting up today? So now it's competition time. If you follow me on my Ant Savage Art Facebook page, you would have seen that we decided to do a little competition and give three of these prints away in a bit of a drive to advertise our newly created YouTube channel. So yeah, we've got a hat full of names and there's three of these prints to be given away. And Hannah's going to do the honours, yeah.
Will I shut my eyes?
Yeah, shut your eyes.
Where is it? Okay, you ready? Drum roll. Blah, 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 blah. First one, first winner. James Beavers. Congratulations.
Get in contact. Number two.
Emma Braithwaite, I recognise that name.
I think
you might have bought some prints. Thank you very much. You get a free one.
And number three.
Gillian Dawson. I think I recognise that name as well.
Yeah, might be a regular.
Thank you, Gillian. Free print.
So thank you all so much for entering the little competition.
I think we're going to do more though, aren't we, along the way? Why not?
I've done it for a long time on my Facebook page because sometimes you just need a bit of a drive.
That, and it's just like a thank you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Being here at the beginning of this new journey and stuff as well.
Yeah. So I think that's us for this week, isn't it?
I think so. What are we doing next week?
I don't know. We'll try and be a bit quicker with the video. Are we going to try for Fridays or Saturdays? End of the week. We'll try and get them done for the end of the week.
Yeah. And I might show some of my pictures next week.
Yes.
And we're out for blacking, so we're going to stay in the cottage. Bath time. Can't wait. See you later.
Bye.